Chapter 3, How to Win Friends and Influence Witches. Let's get something straight. Before I went veggie, I ate children. Lots of them. I felt mildly remorseful when I saw them melting away as my private human chef cooked them. Sure, it was morally wrong. I liked getting richer than a triple hamburger protein so I could hit the gym. I developed my arms into Mr. Universe competition territory, oh yeah. I had biceps that would make me People Magazine's sexiest wolf alive if such a competition existed. Then, I started getting sick. I had to go on a few diets and... Oh, the story. I forgot, I was writing my memoirs. Darn it. Alright. Well, one day, I walked outside to play frisbee. I lost my frisbee on my lunch break. And, oh, because I have dog instincts somewhat, I chased it into Tribeca. Not a good plan. I found it outside a pizzeria. Mmm, pizza. I went inside, about to get a slice of triple cheese. Soon, two brats ordered the last triple cheese slice of pie in the building once they heard me mumbling that I wanted the slice. Yes, they were ahead of me in line.
I'll take that,
a dumb boy said in his school uniform. I already knew he was dumb by looking at his stupid face. Watch your order, puppet face. Aren't you supposed to be in school? I shouted. The boy yelled in a snotty tone.
Aren't you supposed to be in an animal control truck? Oh, good one, bro,
his twin sister jerked. She gave him a high five. Look, brats, I lost my blue frisbee. Walking over here, I got into a big hunger, like hungry like the wolf, that old song I re-sang. I burned up a couple hundred calories on the treadmill before that. Do you mind? I snatched his pizza and ate it in front of him. I snarled, whipping out all of my teeth until drool splattered his face.
Are you going to eat us?
I sure am. Step out of here if you want to live, I lied. It's been some time since I cared to eat children. I saw a famous physician on the TV yesterday saying they were bad for your cholesterol. I can't have none of that. I need to make millions. Millions. Yes.
Ah!
The high school-aged twins ran out. You gonna pay for that? The pizza deli cashier asked. I snarled at her until she said, I guess you can get it for free. Middle of the day sale, you know? I walked out and began chasing the kids. I didn't know what got into me. It felt like I was a wild Alaskan wolf. I was going to win the Iditarod dog race in my mind. I was a speed hog. Oh, did I really just think that? Nah, I can't make hog jokes anymore. What was I doing? Sooner or later, I was going to blurt out politically incorrect pig joke in the public eye. The kids... Sniff, sniff.
Wolf, leave us alone,
the girl screamed. Seeing her twin took my frisbee while I was in line, she scolded him.
Give him his dumb toy so he can leave us alone. He's scaring me.
I unhinged my jaw so expansively scary big, 10 SeaWorld whales could fit inside. I was about to bite the boy for my frisbee when he gave it to me. I said, thank you. You probably stole this because you're jealous of my success. The high school boy replied,
I don't think so. You need like a major spa wax. All that hair? Ew.
Excuse me? I am a wolf. Look who's talking. You couldn't grow chest hair if your life depended on it, pimple toad.
Will you stop making fun of me? It's a result of hormones experienced as...
Kid, I know what causes acne, and no wonder you were at a pizza place. They make a cool dime every time a pizza-faced spokesperson walks in the door. You're as recognizable as the pepperoni slices in the window.
That's not very nice,
his sister said. Yeah, it wasn't very nice stealing my frisbee, I snapped. I curled up the right side of my lips to flash my canine teeth.
Say you're sorry, both of you,
the girl told us.
I'm sorry I took your frisbee. When you said you needed a cheese pizza slice, I could have ordered my favorite instead. The Hawaiian style is better anyway,
the boy said. I'm sorry I made fun of your acne. You're actually uglier. I forgot to talk about your Dumbo haircut made out of wool. Is that natural? I said. I was infuriated.
Wolf?
The girl shoved my stomach. Fine. I'm sorry. I guess I'm so mean because I have anger issues. I'm really frustrated these days because I don't have any friends. I thought I made friends with this flamingo babe, but she doesn't really return my phone calls. Not one. I left her 50 messages last night. Jerk, isn't she? I'm pretty lonesome. After I'm done working, I come home to watch TV. I don't do a whole lot. Before that, I was unemployed. Before I was unemployed, I was framed for a triple homicide.
Whoa, you've worked at an art gallery with picture frames?
The girl asked. No, I... Never mind. Let's just say I'm one lonesome fellow right now. I guess I need to work on my people skills. I shrugged off the info.
I'm Gretel, the girl said. And this is Hansel, my twin brother. We go to that school close to where you work. We've seen you before. You just seem so angry that we were afraid to talk to you.
It's true, Hansel said. Are you two from Germany? I asked.
Wolf, you can't go around asking stuff without knowing people. Yes, we grew up there. Our parents work at the United Nations.
Oh yeah, I can. Sorry. I was gonna say I could say anything I wanted. I guess I offended them being too nosy before I became friends first. My name's Aladdin. You can ask me anything you want about being a wolf, or give me advice, or we can play ping pong, we can go skating, or we could see a movie now, or I can take you to work, or help me find a girlfriend, or...
Maybe first stop leaving 50 messages on a girl's recording machine,
Hansel scoffed at me.
It'll scare them away, Gretel said.
It was not 60 phone messages, I screamed, defending my honor. I left 50.
And how many nights?
Hansel asked. It's none of your business.
Every night of every week this year?
No, like 20 phone calls, then willowing down to 19, then up again until I got to 50? I said, shrugging it off. I don't need her. Please. She's a worthless friend. I can do better.
So why were you calling her nonstop if you didn't need her?
Gretel asked. I misdialed each time and apologized. Moving on, shall we? What can we do now that we became best buds for life? BFFs. The key to my eternal happiness. The peas to my pod. The...
Seriously, Aladdin. We just met you. Give us, like, an hour to know you well.
Gretel said.
No, Gretel. We need to help him. If we don't do something now, he will come off like a desperate loser forever. Please, sis?
Whatever. I don't have much else to do now.
What should we do?
She said. I say, we needed time travel. I said,
that's impossible. Where can we find a time portal anyhow?
Hansel told me. I don't know. Aren't you the cool popular kids who know everything? You tell me, I responded. It must be pretty obvious.
You've watched too many sci-fi movies, Hansel said.
Ain't it the truth? I smiled. Together we looked around a couple blocks. I thought we had it made when we stumbled upon raw green sewage that looked near technicolor, flying bugs and mutant giant rats everywhere feasting on hot dogs. I was wrong. It was normal for Manhattan. I did my best to the environment by crunching on a soda can with my teeth when a nearby recycling bin was full. We walked and walked and walked, and despaired. It appeared time travel was impossible. I couldn't find anything remarkable. We searched uptown and downtown repeatedly for several hours. Nothing. Our search was doomed. Hey, I don't have your phone numbers, I said.
Here you go,
Gretel answered. She programmed their numbers into my phone. Soon she got a phone call, or three, while we walked. Who was it? I was in suspense.
Hello?
She answered each time. How come you don't think the time portal is in the laundromat? I asked over the phone.
Wolf, Aladdin, you're one step ahead of me. I can see you.
No, you can't. I'm invisible.
I sure can. Your suit has a pizza stain on it.
It does not. You must be thinking of another person. I've been told I look a lot like Bradley Cooper.
Who's that?
He's this famous actor. When he was young, he was practically my identical twin.
I'm going to hang out the phone now, dweeb,
Gretel said. She poked me in the back.
Stop acting needy. You're lucky anyone wanted to befriend you. I understand why the flamingo never returned your calls. You probably called her as soon as you left your first meeting, all day and night.
What I do with my free time is none of your business.
So it's true?
Perhaps it's none of your beeswax.
I knew it. Guys, quiet. I'm trying to think if I saw what I think I saw,
Hansel said. He startled us. I realized we were somewhere outside a large townhouse. When I spun around to pull Gretel's hair to be mean, I forgot what I was doing. Our world looked different. All around us, we saw cobblestone streets, horses, gas lanterns, And OMG, I hear Posh Tweed, portrait sign somewhere resembling of a modern day boy band poster, and woman wearing funky dresses. What's with their outfits? It looks like they can hardly breathe, I said.
Those are corset gowns, Gretel said. I read about them in history class. People wore them during the 1800s.
Well, nice parade. I love a parade. Come, will ya? I want to win a stuffed pony today. Grrr, I said. I ran off to ask a person about playing fair games. Excuse me, have you seen the pin the tail on the donkey attraction? I'm very interested, very. And how might I go about arranging some fair tokens? And
I beg my pardon?
The woman asked. Oh right, you probably don't have that anymore. Do you have any of those cool carnival rides? Where can I get funnel cake? Is this a Renaissance fair? Oh, you're in character. Are you from 1492 when Columbus sailed the ocean blue? Can I get my corn dog? Do you have any roller coasters?
Sir, you ask many peculiar questions. I do not know the answers to them. I suggest you search for your missing children. They went into the witch's townhouse. Beware of her.
The woman pointed behind me and stepped into her horse and buggy. As I turned, I saw an enormous home. It was like the fancy Fifth Avenue places I see when I go by the park. But this one was made of gumdrops, gingerbread, cake frosting, and licorice. I immediately went to go eat it. I have a sweet tooth problem. Well, you saw what happened with the chocolate soy milk. Munch, munch, munch. I munched on the house until the front door toppled. A woman showed up. She was a fox. Literally and figuratively. She took my breath away. I couldn't help but whistle loudly.
Quiet, you! I grow tired of wolf whistles, the fox said. Run for your life. I was about to be murdered. 2 schoolchildren are inside, tied to sticks. You must hurry.
She ran away before I could get her phone number. I wandered inside the manor. This fair looks a lot like the 75th and 5th Avenue. I didn't understand what happened. Did we go back in time, or was I delusional?
The witch is going to cook us. Help!
She was on top of a cutting board, her hands and feet tied together. Why do you look all red? I don't like that blush on you, I told her.
It's paprika, Wolf. The witch is seasoning me.
Pamika, is that a new drugstore brand? I don't keep up with women too well.
Paprika! It's an herb, Aladdin. Don't you read?
I only read stock books. I don't need to cook. Hello, I live in a high-end hotel. I call down to room service when I want something or hire a personal chef.
Thanks for wasting time, the witch is here after a quick potty break. Thanks for the introduction, darling. And who is this creature?
A green-skinned woman asked, wielding a rusty butcher knife. Why is your skin green? Man, I tried that mask once at a hotel spa downstairs. Ripped my flesh off like crazy. Come to think of it, I got bad hives. My dermatologist charged me around $1,500 to fix the problem, I said. Is that brand expensive?
I have green witch skin, you fool. I will grind your adopted children's bones to make my gingerbread.
Take them. That dumb girl won't answer my phone calls anyway. At this point, I've had enough with being in the middle of the cannibalism drama. First my hotel chef and the giants, and that grinding line. So overexposed a statement if you ask me. In a week you'll all be saying, I will saute your blood to make my herbal tea. I sure hate culinary vernacular, if you ask me.
I wasn't, the witch exclaimed.
And furthermore, did you realize how much cholesterol is in children? And I'm talking the fit ones. One time I ate this child who failed gym class twice, and whoa, was that a conversation starter. The fat spilled over my new cookware.
Shut your mouth, you lunatic! I am in the middle of a baking project, she screamed in my ear.
Hey now, there's no need to get rude. I learned a good lesson about friendship today. You should apologize.
Yeah, and friends rescue each other, Gretel shouted.
The witch stuffed an onion in her mouth to silence her.
Ew, you just gave a bad breath. All the better to season her, my dear, the witch said. Did you say you ate children before? You know how to cook them, don't you? I could use some help.
I did eat them. I guess I know something from watching my chef do it back then.
What tastes good? I'm dying to try something new. Paprika is boring me.
I hated children tata.
What's that?
The witch asked. This crazy dish I got once at a wolf French restaurant in Quebec. It's French canine Canadian for raw child.
Gross. Undercooked meat is a health hazard.
Yes, it gave me the runs. Do you like Thai peanut sauce for leg muscles?
Sometimes. Do you know how to make it?
It dawned on me. Maybe I had to rescue the spoiled brats. I had never had real friends before. As tasty as they might have been for the witch if I didn't help them escape. I did the next craziest thing to start my stock consultant business from the money tree harvesting. I told the witch about my dream of writing my memoirs. I wanted to be a published author. If I didn't have these children to motivate me, there's no way I was going to convince a nation of people to learn about the importance of friendship in making money at your day job. And that's why I can't let you eat them.
I must eat them now,
she said, unimpressed. I admire your spirit. How'd you like to come work for me in the future? You have to be the most aggressive witch I've ever met.
What would I have to do?
Crunch numbers, stuff like that. You know a lot about cooking. I'm willing to help you open a restaurant.
I don't know about that. I always wanted to own a golf supply shop. Maybe sell dresses I design inside.
She blushed. I like the idea. What makes your dresses so special?
They're made out of gingerbread and candy, licorice, gumdrops, candy galore.
The witch had an oddly happy smile I haven't seen since I watched PBS children's shows for baby wolves. Don't you remember Cecil Wolf Street? A classic, if ever. Man, that was the best. I've been meaning to look into becoming an entrepreneur. What say I open a woman's clothing boutique and make your designs all the rage in future New York? Let's go back to my era.
Not so fast. I need to set these children free first. Didn't you say you needed them?
These old things? I guess so. I untied both Hansel and Gretel. Then I ate the raw onion that was previously stuffed in Gretel's mouth after I peeled away the contaminated pot. Ew.
Let's go,
Hansel said. Hold up. I'm going to get a bank account opened. To create lots of interest, basically money earned when your cash sits in the bank as the bank's way of thanking you, I created a savings account at a bank nearby under Ugly Green Witch Enterprises. I had to rename the account because the witch found it a bit cruel. She thought she was pretty. Do you own a mirror? I told her, and soon I forced myself to apologize when I remembered my new friendship motto. We changed the savings account name to Tamami Hall Era Green Witch Warts and All. Over the years between this time and the future, though it went by like a short infomercial when we time-traveled back, we generated heaps of money from savings from our initial $5 investment. We used the money to develop our new clothing store. Pretty soon, Bloomingdale started carrying my line of Aladdin the Big Bad Wolf inventory like gingerbread sneakers and preserved peppermint swimwear. I was branching out. I was finally becoming an entrepreneur, shedding my big bad notoriety.